Some serious work have we got put in at Westmoreland. Yes, man. The police and the soldier them have got besiege Westmoreland. Search the whole place. Turn it upside down. Correl the whole place. Cause the amount of family we weep on a morning now. 4 people get wet up, including a police officer. Within hours, you know. What this man?
Bag of things, they have to make a statement. If I know bag of things, TV, it don't make sense. A bag of things, TV, I run things all the time. Bag of things, TV, media.
A number of serious operations have got dropped in a Westmoreland. The dirty criminal boy then could have run out of their mother frack, run out of a bed and run out of a cellar. Them not gonna get away from this. Ladies and gentlemen, Chantelle Westmoreland, a 47-year-old police constable, was among 4 people who get wet up hours apart in this Western parish between Friday night and Saturday morning. The death of the police constable Richard Barrett was too much for members of the Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, and his family, or his wife, who was unable to speak with the observer. You know? The wife dropped down a groan. However, other members of the family spoke with the newspaper, including his 17-year-old son, Junior, who is trying to cope with the losing of his father. Hallelujah, boy. May I tell a boy? Now, in quotation, here where man son has seen a policeman son, look at Junior, you know. Junior, you know. At 17, he died. He didn't even get to see me graduate from high school. It is really hard, expressed Junior, who paused for a while to regain his composure. I wasn't expecting this at this young age. There is a time in life where everyone has to pay their due, but I never expect this one in my life. Are they Junior? You see me, I say, very intelligent youth, you know. I go on good in a school and bag of things me a year, you know. And see the little youth watching father gone on the drain, you know, man. John, no boy. Selassie, I know a star. You know a star, I say, no. The cop left his location around 6 Friday, even when he reportedly received a call from friends from them to meet and have a drink, even though his bar that has a restaurant attached was closed on Good Friday, he went. However, it appeared gunmen showed up at his bar before his colleagues shortly after 8 p.m. You know, saying, so a man didn't know a bill wait for his friend them and the gun boys and show up before a man friend them come on then. A man just a go on easy cause a Good Friday, see away. Passerby reportedly saw a white car with 3 men lingering outside the property. Friends upon arrival found Barrett slumped over the counter. His loaded firearm, which was on his counter, was not stolen. Barrett was rushed to the Savannah Mar Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. Junior was sleeping when the shocking news of his father's death came. He said it took a while for it to sink in. Because when Junior hear the news, he must say, "Una move from yourself with the foolishness, man. I lie on tell. My father not dead, man." Junior couldn't believe. Hear what he must say now. Junior said Constable Barrett was a loving, caring, and good father who taught him a lot. The man a good father, man. Look at, watch it, man. A whole lot of father missing out of people, them and the kids, them life in Jamaica, you know. And all because the criminals, them are kill the father, them. We have fatherless society. No father in their home, in some of the home them we're talking about, you know. One of favorite garrison them, and some of them places, no father no in them. See? If you know, say, a father get dropped out of now, man, he burned my money, but, hey, me not lie, to man. About 3 if you don't know me, I do upon this case, you know. Because me can't take me see what's really going on in Jamaica, you know. You understand what I say? No, the paper goes on to say the slain cop served in the Jamaica Fire Brigade in Hanover before switching career approximately 20 years ago. At the time of the 47 years old death, he was serving at Little London Police Station, also in Westmoreland. So he did a fireman before in turn police, you know. The man has served Jamaica, you know, for a long, long time. Despite a change in career, the son said it never crossed his mind that his father was leaving a risky job for even a riskier one, noting that his father loved his job. His brother Alden Hunter, who is also a fireman, said that the news was difficult for their mother, who was also or always fearful each time she heard of policeman's death. The whole family are mourn. All because of some nasty nigga where no serve no purpose in Jamaica. You have some little waste man on the street, man. Me I tell you, say, when the police lick off their head and mash them up now,
You find out a boy in the come and run, come down now and say, yo, what is this? What go on? What really go on? So, but them a boy cause so much problem in the Jamaican people, them life. Now they must say, Hunter said Constable Barrett is the eldest of four brothers, and the family look up to him to ensure all was in order. He is a peacemaker who everybody looks towards to ensure certain things are getting done. Hunter said, you know, the time brother, you know. Chavelle Monteith, Constable Barrett's stepdaughter, who works at the bar, was not around at the time of the shooting. Maybe she did it then wet her up to, you know. Yeah, man, and even if I bought her, maybe, man. Them a boy and now left without shoot somebody, you know. Yeah, man, them have to shoot somebody, man. Me I tell some boy, having a business in Westmoreland and them place right now. It come like say a suicidal business here running. Judge, me I tell you, set away. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the second incident, body of man, woman found in graveyard near church in Westmoreland. And Westmoreland, we're there again, you know, man. How would they blow clear this? I know Tivoli Yard over there. I know Rima, I know Jungle. On a Mountain View, saying on a Warwick Hill, a Westmoreland was still there. I can't tell you, the Westmoreland police are probing the circumstances under which a man and a woman were found shot to death with the hands bound in a graveyard in close proximity to the church in Dundee District, Bethel Town, in the parish on Saturday. Tie up their hand back at them and shoot them. A burnt out brown Toyota Probox motor car was found nearby. Hold on, them man. Kiss me neck. But hold on. What government told about this? What the government is going to do about this? Because this is a boss Russia now. This is a gun way past Russia now, ladies and gentlemen. Watch it. Two somebody unbound and tie up. And then dash the people them in the one graveyard. Charge a star. They must say while the identities of the victim have not yet been ascertained, the police said the male appears to be in his late 40s and about 5 feet 11 inches tall. He was wearing a grey t-shirt, light blue jean short pants, and a pair of blue Adidas sneakers. The woman, who is believed to be in her early 30s, is of brown complexion and about 5 feet 7 inches. She was wearing a purple and white mesh blouse, black and white long tights, and a pair of black slippers. According to the police, residents reportedly heard gunshot at about 3 a.m. and later discovered the body about 3:30 a.m. Boy, I'm tell you, the government of Jamaica have a lot of work to be done. Whole heap of work the government of Jamaica have to do. Because he have to spend the money down at Westmoreland. He have to spend it down at Black River, La Covra, St. Elizabeth, St. James. He gonna have to spend all that money them what they usually put in their pocket, you know. You understand? Because they create the guns they come in the country. Create the ways for the youth them to take up a gun. And now everything are backfire now. Watch it. The whole place turned upside down, you know. Jesus God, boy, me I tell you. The paper goes on to say the woman was found in a kneeling position between two graves with what appeared to be a gunshot wound to the head, while the man was found lying down with a wound to the head, his hand tied with a black electrical cord. The bodies were removed to the morgue as the investigation got underway. They are sitting there, some execution, sitting there, man. A Dominican Republic, what we call it, Ecuador, South American, bad country, them man, Mexico alone. Me hear them a sitting here, boy. I can't Jamaica this to blood plate. I must want a different country. No, sir. This a look like a joke thing right now. You reach a level where it come like a some video game thing, you know, on PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 4 and Xbox. No, man, a joke sitting there, my man. They man sitting here, can't go on a Jamaica so vicious. Man, now, woman, tie up her head back, lick out. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what you are going to know. Fiery protests in West Kingston after a man is fatally shot by a police. You know? Big protests are going on the right now. They must say angry residents stage a fiery protest in West Kingston following reports that a man from the community was fatally wet up by members of the island security forces on Saturday. You know? Full details of the incident are still unclear, but reports are that the incident took place at about 10:54 p.m. Sources report that after hearing of the shooting, angry residents have been blocking several roads leading into the community. A large contingent of police and soldiers are now in the area trying to bring the situation under control. You know? Yeah, man. I be sitting there going, boy, I tell us, Jaja, please turn upside down, you know. People are dead from left to right. And the politician, they know say they will reach us, you know. all when them a play around and a go on and allow the guns to come in their country. The government of Jamaica now tighten up all in time that them a fight politics war and them a play around and a play politics. Now everything reached the climax and now. See that? Be a gun a fire, bugger sitting a go on. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, but I'm hopeful that things will come better. And I just go through a phase right now. Ladies and gentlemen, I could go and do the right thing. Support the law enforcers, them, where I do the right thing. Serve and protect, you know. The bad politician, them, we are going to hold them accountable and we are going to burn them out. See, away. You understand? We have to build, but Jamaica can get it right away. You just go through a little shake-up phase right now. Things that have been done in the early stage of life, you know, the seed that they plant. I eat them a rape you now. So, when we hope for the government to know, spend all our money on crime and violence. When you do that now, guess what now? The country are going to build because we're going to have more investors. The Jamaicans, they will come back into the country because they feel secure. Money will continue spending. Look at the athletes, them, young athletes, them. They will mash up the career for game right now. We have so many talent. Jamaicans are so talented and blessed. Why would we make crime or take over the country? We want to plant that the seed there. See, and allow criminality for real in Jamaica for the longest while. We are born out the politician, them on the prime minister. They have to be held accountable. Ladies and gentlemen, support the platform of Bagger Things Media TV. Support the law enforcers because they might do their job on them for be blamed. And the bigger heads, them. We don't know the thing already. Up and running. Bang, 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 bang.
Bagger Things Media TV, man. Thank you for watching. Make sure you share it. Make sure you subscribe. Press that notification bell to stay updated, man. Jamaican assassin killing all names. Urban legend. Jackal out.